Hello everyone, my name is William Amzalag and I want to welcome you to our 33rd episode of Jeunesse Longevity TV and the 7th episode of Healthy Lifestyle. Stress, the disease of the century. Chronic stress is terrible. It can set the stage for chronic diseases, including diabetes and cancer. It can also make you more susceptible to colds, flu, and other infection. And psychological stress can disrupt your homeostasis, your hormonal balance and inflammatory response. It can also affect your state of mind, your working memory, your ability to control your impulses, and therefore increasing the risk of anxiety and depression. Worst, stress can sap your energy, undermine your motivation, especially if you want to lose weight. To get control over your stress, we will follow some strategy. The first one is to develop better time management skills. Prioritize what needs to be done as soon as you can get to it, and take care immediately on tasks and responsibility that are next online. Second, lighten your plate of responsibility. Learn to say no to non-essential requests. Delegate. Third, the way you think about stress can make it better or worse. So stop negative thinking habits, such as looking at the worst case scenario or taking things personally, and try to find a more neutral way to think about what's happening. Ask yourself whether you have evidence that you are saying to yourself is actually true. Fourth, discover your optimal tension-reducing technique. I mean by that, it could be meditation, progressive muscle relaxation, visualization, or simply breathing session. Learn to breathe slowly and rhythmically. Find what works for you and use it on a regular basis. 5. Sound sleep. The quality and the quantity of your sleep has profound effects on your body and mind. One of the effects of chronic sleep deprivation is that it lowers the pain threshold. In other words, everything that hurts, hurts more when you are lacking sleep. Moreover, sleep directly affects your brain waves, which can get out of sync with your lifestyle. And that can cause irritability, less focus, frustration, anger, and depression. Here are some tips. Maintain a consistent sleep schedule. This means stick with the same bedtime and awakening time. Avoid napping during the day. Stay clear to stimulant too close to bedtime. Exercise regularly during the day. Avoid bringing stress and worries to bed with you. Make sure that your bedroom is quiet and dark enough. 6. Take care of your social life. We are highly influenced by our relationship with others. Simply having friends helps protect your health. people with good social networks tend to be physically and psychologically more resilient and more optimistic. Here are some tips to enhance your social network. 1. Find out who is the most supportive people in your life and do that well before you need their support. You will feel better knowing that. Maintain a spirit of give and take. Make sure it continues to be a two-way street. 3. Ask for help to people you trust and let the family and friends help you manage your challenge better. 4. Expand your social circle by joining groups when you feel comfortable. So to wrap up, each of these factors, stress management, regular sleep, social support, can improve the state of your health on their own. But on top, they can have a accumulating, synergistically positive effect on your well-being. And remember, reversing a bad health trajectory often begin with only one little choice moving in the opposite direction. It can be better nutrition, regular physical activity, better sleep, or better stress management. My name is William Amzalag, and I am Generation Young. See you at our next episode. Bye-bye.